What's the first thing that comes to your mind when a pop-up window covers the book you were browsing? I bet it's something like, where's the exit button? Yeah, pop-ups can be annoying, but only when they aren't used properly. Let's discuss how you can turn the most annoying thing on the web into a conversion goldmine. Hi everyone, I'm Alex, and in this video, we'll be talking about pop-ups, sort of a marketing castaway tool. Pop-ups scare off website visitors. Pop-up creator Ethan Zuckerman publicly apologized for inventing them, yet pop-ups don't leave marketers' toolkits. But why? The answer is simple. Pop-ups actually work. As of 2022, the average pop-up conversion rate is around 11%, and it's not as high as emails or chatbots, but it's still not zero. I'll break down some of the behavioral principles that explain the efficiency of pop-ups. Pop-ups boost the fear of missing out. They set a special offer deadline to urge the user to take action. Amazing trick, never gets old. In fact, I bought a pair of cycling shoes at 20% off this way a couple of weeks back. Pop-ups offer instant gratification. Users complete the desired action and immediately receive a promised perk. That's a win-win. Pop-ups get users' attention. You just can't ignore the pop-up if you want to continue browsing. This means there's a chance you might get your message across if you bring enough value to it. Let's just admit it, everyone hates pop-ups because they appear rapidly and nobody knows why. But how about we stick to some rules that help us create meaningful pop-ups? So, rule number one, pop-up on time. What annoys me the most is when a pop-up jumps out right after I land on the website. My idea of revenge is leaving that website for good. Let your visitors look around and get to know your website before they interact with it. But when is the perfect moment? I'd recommend exploring your website Google Analytics. First, you need to know how long the average session lasts. Next, set up the display time at halfway that period. Say the average session lasts a minute, so the user will be ready to interact with your pop-up 20-30 seconds after they land on the page. Moreover, SendPulse allows you to use smart pop-ups. They are the pop-ups that appear at over 20 different conditions. Apart from time on the site, multiple user actions and conditions can trigger a pop-up. But don't take my word for it. Go and check it out for yourself. Okay, rule number two, bring value. This is what can save your pop-up from being mercilessly shut down. Yes, pop-ups are annoying, but being polite and helpful can turn the tables. Always check the tone and the message of your pop-up to avoid being out of line. Even if you use an informal tone of voice, try to stay professional. Avoid addressing hot social issues, don't use explicit words, and always be friends with your customers. Also, make sure your pop-up offers value for the user. In e-commerce, it's easy. Just offer a discount or a free delivery. For other industries, the value is different. For example, you can offer a checklist for those who subscribe to your mailing list from the landing page. No matter what you are offering, add a countdown timer to your pop-up. The FOMO effect is a bulletproof way that encourages to take action. And finally, rule number three. Think of the design. The design isn't just about colors, it's about the place, shape, sound, fonts, and content. Loads of factors. Use the most appropriate format for your pop-up window for the best performance. For example, new visitors will be happy to see the welcome pop-up with the special offer. Before opening the large file, especially on the mobile device, the yes/no pop-up option allows users to decide if they want to download it. Avoid flashy colors and snappy visuals and sound effects. And test it. That will help you understand whether the pop-up looks best, if it's responsive, or if there is an exit button. We don't recommend full-screen overlapping pop-ups. Site visitors often cannot distinguish the page content from the pop-up and leave the page quickly. Use overlays if there is no alternative solution. Of course, there are some more design tricks. I will share them in my next video. And that's a wrap for today. Subscribe to the SendPulse channel and stay tuned for more useful tips. Take care.